Recording. Okay. Everything's all set up, I think. Alright, so let's explore this shit together. I don't know how much you guys have seen the spoiler logs, but we'll go through all the cards together and whatever. Click to view reward track. So whenever you complete your daily objectives, you not only get coins, but you also get EXP, which helps you level up. And, based on your level, you get rewards, which is cool. What is this about? Is this the bonus track at the bottom? Purchase the Mastery Pass to unlock. Well, can we buy the Mastery Pass, man?
You need 3,400 crystals.
I thought you said they take it out.
No, to buy additional levels.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's stupid. Okay. Oh, whatever. Justin was saying something about a cute Liliana. I'm gonna look for it. Card style. Ooh, these are cool. Oh, sleeves?
Talking about the weeb Liliana?
Yeah. Let me look at you. What the fuck? Okay. Oh, Liliana's only 4,000 too? That's actually pretty great. Nissa looks great. I want Nissa. But I'm pretty happy with Narset. Oh god, I really want that though. But I don't have enough gems. I could probably drum up some gems in a bit. Guys, if you're in the store, we got two codes. One of them is level up. Hell yeah. And the other is play M20. I mean, Liliana is only for gems, so hell yeah. Okay. So let's look at the level up system together, and then... Oh, we'll look at the cards and shit. So, just boosters, a Mastery Orb, boost this level by spending gems. So the Mastery Orb is what helps you level up, I guess? Can I... I gotta click down here. Boosters. Oh, you get mythics and shit. What's at the end? Wow, you get nothing at the end. The fuck? Okay, so Brian, leveling up to 100 doesn't matter because the last reward is 72 anyway.
For the free-to-play check.
Yes.
But if you went the 100-day one, then you can get like the Chandra card sleeves and the cat and all that bullshit.
Yeah, M20 Chandra exquisite sleeves, but no one gives two shits about Chandra. I'm not about to spend any money on this. Sorin. They gotta drop the cost of the Mastery Pack, I'm pretty sure. Oh, the cat's okay. I don't really like it. Apparently you can spam it like fuck and it's really annoying. Mastery Tree. Oh, you can put the Mastery Orbs here. That's cool. So you can unlock card styles in here too. That is dope. Dude, fucking Omnath, hell yeah. Yeah, you can use your regular Mastery Orbs in here, I believe. That's what it's for. Yeah, these are Mastery Orbs. So you can get additional Mastery Orbs going down here. Oh, hell yeah, that's cool. Raise the alarm. I don't have any orbs. Oh, from your regular level ups? No, because this is for core set specifically. You need core set Mastery Orbs. I think. I'm not, maybe. I'm not 100% sure of that. You might be able to. Because I don't have any Mastery Orbs because I didn't play at that time. You can't? Okay. Blue or black spells? Get the fuck out of here. Come on. White or black spells? Fuck me. Okay. What's wrong with my bronze? You chill out. Constructed or limited? Okay. Set masteries. Sure. Well, let's go to the store, see what else is new, and then we'll maybe buy some shit. There's a lot of War of the Spark. I don't open the boosters I get from just winning. A new avatar? I don't see a new avatar. God, these things are dope. Karn's like, I have no pants on. This is super great. I'm on the avatar page. It's just Hualtly and Angrath. These two have always been here. Oh, profile. Oh, I already own the avatar is what you're saying.
Get out of my way.
Wait, what?
I'm burning up here.
Excuse me. I don't understand. Plus 10 level save, 20%. Fuck off. So you can buy levels, Brian, just not a lot. Wow. Okay. Oh. You guys redeem your codes? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Fuck. How many packs did I get? I bought 10. Okay. I broke the game. I'm gonna buy a War of Spark pack. No, I'm not. I'm just gonna open 10. I said I bought 9, but I only had three. No, you're right. I had 4 because I got 3 free ones and then 1 from the level up. When you cast a non-creature spell, it tanks becomes a creature. It gets +1/+1. Sure. There's another Karn. Aniko. Yes, gold wild cards. I love these things. Why did I get 10? Because I opened 10 packs. Chandra, Solar Blaze. It's another Krenko! we're making Krenko happen. Don't care. Don't care. Give me rare wild cards. That's what I want. Blast zones are good. I'll take that.
Think you can beat me?
Don't care about you.
You're welcome to try.
I don't think I'll ever play Izzet. Idiot Drakes. Oh my god, it's my fourth Krenko! You guys are fucked! Oh, today's been a good day. Off of Kaya, that's alright. I don't really run black. Okay, that's alright. There's another God Eternal. Spark Doubles is good. Okay. We're just gonna open these one at a time so we can explore the cards. Oh, that's stupid. Actually, you know what? I got a better idea. How about let's actually read through all the cards? And then we'll open the packs. Corset. We'll go with just commons first. Enchanted creature. Enchanted creature gets +1/+3 when it enters the battlefield. Tap tracker. Dude, I can put this in Fat Bottom Bitches! That's actually not a bad card. Attention gets flying and you draw a card. That's a pretty good cantrip. Another Concordia Pegasus and Daybreak Champions. I already have enough of those. Disenchant is back. Holy fuck. Dude, this card is so good. For 2 mana, instant speed, destroy target artifact or enchantment. That can get first strike. That's okay. Enchanted creature cannot attack or block. That's actually not that good. You don't want to run that ever. Target creature gets +2/+4 into end of turn. That's not that great. I can't select this card. Destroy tapped creature. You gain 1 life for each creature you control with flying. Destroy tapped creature. Okay. Anything good here? Another creature gets flying. Inspired Charge is pretty good. I know a lot of Boros decks will be running that. It gets +1/+1 for each. It gets a +1/+1 counter for each other creature you control. That'll be good in saps or whatever. If you control another Fairy Miscreant, you can draw a card. On summons are good. This is such a dick card. Oh, nice creature you got. Next turn you're attacking me, put it back in your hand. Go to top 3 cards, put one in your hand, the rest of the bottom. That's very good for 2 mana. Befuddle, Zephyr Charge, that's okay. Negates are back. 3/3 Defender, not bad. Enter the battlefield, draw a card, not that great. I mean, it's pretty good for a draft, but... Convolute. Counter unless they pay 4. Get fucked. Crosslinks. Tap another creature. Does not untap its next step. Can't be blocked. That's very good. 3/4, 2/2 can't be blocked. Whenever another blue creature enters the battlefield under control, target player mills 2. Fuck off. Oh, that's too expensive. If it was 3, that would be great. But that's pretty expensive for just a wallish thing. Don't care. Counter target spell, draw a card, fuck off. This spell costs 1 less if you control a creature with flying, draw 2 cards. That's pretty good. Tap target creature, does not untap, that's very strong. But for 4, maybe not. Spells like target this cost 2 more. Can't be blocked. Sacrifice a creature, destroy a creature. Return target creature card from your graveyard to your hand for 1 mana. Seems strong. Duress is back. John's gonna be making a deck off of this again. Blade Brand's back. Target creature gets +1/+3. Nope. Don't care. Target player discards 2 cards. Get fucked. Destroy target creature. Oh, murder's back. If you guys like it. Begin your end step. Don't care. Return 2 creatures to your hand. Costs more, but it's a single card, so you get more value out of it. That's a burn card, but kind of sucks. That's alright. When I enter the battlefield, destroy target creature. Any opponent controls that was dealt damage this turn. Sure. Six, five, just straight up. 5/5 death touch. So, this is this card that Brian was showing me, the Infuriate. That's going into Krenko. It's so stupid. Because you have a red, almost giant growth, and then giant growth. Reckless Airstrike. Deals 3 damage to target creature with flying, or destroy artifact. Oh, John should put these in the fucking, his... Pugurb deck, because of how it's that one card where if he attacks with a creature power 1 or less, it deals 1 damage to whatever it's attacking. It does it already. Shocks are back. Use this to only cast an elemental or Chandra spell. Gotham Assailant. Chandra creature gets +2/+2. Can't block. Alright, Kyle, we're just gonna run through these real quick, and then I'll be ready. I'll gotta move my packs to make a deck or so. I'm not seeing anything great for red. Looking through the packs, I knew that red was gonna get shafted this time. Titanic Growth is back, Rabid Bite is back. This Mystic sucks because it's two. It's a Llanowar or Elf for two. And Llanowar or Elf will be getting cycled out soon, which kind of sucks. Gift of Paradises are very good for ramp decks. I should be running those. And then a bunch of lifelands. Cool. Okay. Let's look at the uncommons. Target creature you control gains protection from a color of your choice until end of turn. For one? And you scry? That's dumb. Sure, that's fine. Ancestral Blade gets a sword attached to it. Protection from black as a card from a graveyard. Put target creature power 4 or greater in the bottom of its owner's library. Just get out of here. If you were to gain life, gain that much plus 1. Enchanted creature gets plus 0 plus 2, assigns combat damage equal to its toughness rather than power. It's okay, but this is only a single target for the same cost of high alert, so it's not that good. Rule of Law is actually pretty solid against combo decks. If you have 25 or more life, it has double strike. Plus one, plus one counter on something of flying. Draw a card, discard a card, draw a card. Counter target spell or permanent that's red or green. Put it at the bottom of your library. Shut up, Blue. Return target creature you control and each aura attached to it to its owner's hands. Creatures with flying you cast cost one less to cast. So it looks like flying is going to be a thing in this set. This is almost like Deadweight but worse. Well, kind of better because it's a speed actually. 1-1 for a Death Touch lifelink? For one? Okay, that's fine. Destroy target creature or planeswalker that's green or white. Oh, there's a Vampire Lord, but it's kind of expensive. This spell can't be countered. Deals 5 damage to target creature or planeswalker that is white or blue. Novice Chandra. Elementals get plus 2, plus 0. Add double red. Does 2 damage to any target. Goblin Ringleader's good. Only for Goblin decks, though. Create 2 treasure tokens. That could be good in a ramp deck. Especially if you're playing dragons. Dragon Mage. When it deals combat damage to a player, each player discards their hand and draws 7 cards. Draw a card if an opponent has cast a blue or black spell this turn. Spells you control can't be countered this turn. You and permanents you control gain hexproof from blue and black until end of turn. Hey, Esper, fuck off. God, that's so good. When a creature enters the battlefield, you control Scry 1. Whenever you cast a spell that targets a creature you control, draw a card. That's really strong. Pulse of Murasa, that's one of John's favorite cards for green. Just return target creature or land card from your graveyard to its hand. To their owner's hand, and then you gain 6 life. Thrashy Bronchodon's back. Make a wolf, and it gets stronger. Creatures you control get plus 2, plus 2. And trample. I don't think any of these are great. Sacrifice Cryptic Cage, draw a card. Activate if you only have 5 or more lands, which is not that great. Manifold Key, Diamond Knight. Oh, Meteor Golem's back. choose a card name, then reveal the top card of your library. If that card has a chosen name, sacrifice the Diviner's Lockbox and draw 3 cards. Activate this ability only time you can cast a sorcery. Well, that's pretty easy to do when you scry a lot. Alright, let's move on to the fun stuff here. When an angel enters the battlefield you control, you gain 4. When an angel you control dies, create a 1/1 spirit. This card is one of the most broken cards in the set, brought back. Choose up to 2 target permanent cards in your graveyard that were put there from the battlefield this turn. Return them to the battlefield tapped. That is, do it without scry. Can I do it with Surveil? But this card is very good, I'll show you why. Starfield Mystic. Chimics you cast are 1 less. Hanged Executioner, Exile Target Creature. Leyline of Sanctity, I'm going to be running these because they're really fucking good. If they're in your opening hand at the beginning of the game, you can put it on the battlefield immediately. You have Hexproof. So, Esper Control can't. Thought Erasure you. Burn Dex can't hit you. Destroy all non-land permanents. Sephiroth Skiesblade. You may tap a white and 4 untapped creatures you control with flying rather than pay this spell's mana cost. Flying, lifelink, other creatures you control with flying have indestructible. Alright. Just play white weedy flyers and just drop this bitch. Touch a target, activated ability, triggered ability, or legendary spell. Look at the top 7 cards of your library, put 2 of them in your hand and the rest at the bottom. And so this is good because for 4 you draw basically 2 cards, but going 7 deep. Dungeon Geist, Anticipation. So there's 5 ley lands, they all come into play if you have them in your opening hand. This one lets you cast spells if they had flash. That makes blue and Esper a little bit stronger, but not by a lot. I don't care about that. Atemesis. Draw 2 cards and discard a card. When it deals damage to an opponent, you may reveal your hand of the card with at least 6. If cards with at least 6 different converted mana costs are revealed this way, that player loses the game. What the fuck? I didn't see this card before. 6 different mana costs, huh? That's wild. Return all non-land permanents to the owner's hand. If you return 4 or more non-token permanents you control this way, you may put a permanent from your hand onto the battlefield. That's really strong. I can see a lot of blue decks just running counter spells until they hit this thing. When Agent of Treachery enters the battlefield, gain control of target permanent at the beginning of your end step. If you control 3 or more permanents you don't own, draw 3 cards. 1 for a 1/2 at the beginning of your end step. If a player lost 4 or more life this turn, put a +1/+1 counter on it. Choose 2 target players. Each of them search their library for a card, then shuffles their library and puts a card on top of it. What the fuck? For 1? I can see Esper running that, and that's bad. Oh, what can you do with this? You can do a lot of stupid things with this. Exile target creature an opponent controls a converted mana cost 2 or less. All other creatures of that player controls with the same name as that creature. Then they reveal their hand, and you exile all cards from their hand in graveyard. It's pretty good. It doesn't hit the deck, though. This card, Kyle, if you want to play Dinosaurs again, this is the card you want. For 3 mana, it's a 7/6. Sure, you discard a card at the beginning of your upkeep, but who gives a shit? You draw a card and lose 1 life, or deals 2 damage to any target and you gain 2 life. Leyline of Void, everything gets exiled instead of going to the graveyard. Soren's Guide. When it enters the battlefield, search your library for a graveyard for a name called Soren Vampire Lord. Reveal it from your hand. Gravewalker, we've seen before. Pay 2 life, target creature gets -1/-1 trying to turn. When you lose life, draw that many cards. That's really good. I thought that was a revolver at first. Chandra's Regulator. Whenever you activate a loyalty ability of Alva Chandra Planeswalker, you may pay one. If you do copy that, you may choose new targets for that copy. Marauding Raptor. This is the other dinosaur card I was talking about, Kyle. This card is sick. Creature spells you cast cost one less to cast. Whenever another creature enters a battlefield under your control, Marauding Raptor deals 2 damage to it. If a dinosaur is dealt damage this way, Marauding Raptor gets +2/+0 to end a turn. What? So, like, turn 1, Llanowar or Elf or whatever, or something. Turn 2, Marauding Raptor. Turn 3, my Null Hyferix costs 3. That's it. Instead of 4. Yes, it would kill your Llanowar, but, I mean, this is basically Llanowar itself, because it pays for 1 colorless mana. Sure, it doesn't get green, but it's a body. Makes you dinosaurs, or it makes all your creatures cost less. And it's just good. And it's a 2/3, so it doesn't die to shock. And you play the super fat bottom bitches, or fat dinosaur creatures anyway, quickly, so then you get Galta out there, and it's whatever. So, I want to make a deck around these. I'm going to see how many I can get. I only have 3 wild cards right now, so I'm going to be making some pretty jank decks. Here's another Chandra. Put a loyalty counter on each red planeswalker you control. Create 2 red elementals with haste, sacrifice them. You may cast target instant sorcery, converted mana cost 3 or less from your graveyard. Yes, exactly. That's the point. It's supposed to do all your enrage stuff, and it's dumb and great. I love it. So then you do like the Needle Raptor, so it shoots for 5 damage. You got the Polymorph one where it'll multiply itself. Wait. Hold on. I just thought of something. Oh, why don't I have any filters on? Oh, because of rare. Can I make infinite polyraptors? Guys. Guys, can we make infinite polyraptors? So polyraptor says when it's dealt damage, create a token of it, right? And then when another creature enters a battlefield under your control, Marauding Raptor deals 2 damage to it. So, Polyraptor hits the field. Marauding Raptor shoots it for 2. Polyraptor takes damage, multiplies to another Polyraptor, hits the field. Marauding Raptor deals 2 damage to that. Does that work? Can you literally make infinite Polyraptors? Apparently I got disconnected from my chat room. Did it work? No, we're good. Oh, I kind of want to test it. Overflow their stack with polyraptors. Did polyraptor say that you may? So here's the downside to polyraptor. It's, it'll fall off because these will become unusable soon. Does this cause a draw because it goes on? It's not you may, so it causes an infinite loop. That's fucked up. Guys, that's fucked up. I don't like that. Okay, let's continue on. Chandra, the big Chandra. +1 is really good. Actually, no, that's not the right Chandra. This is the right Chandra. +2, each opponent gets an emblem at the beginning of your upkeep, this emblem deals 1 damage to you. So you just give them a whole bunch of damage dealing shit. Leyland Combustion. Whenever you or target, or at least one permanent you control, becomes a target to spell an ability an opponent controls, it deals 2 damage to that player. Whenever you cast an instant spell, cast a sorcery spell, or activate a loyalty, copy that. Twice. When this enters the battlefield, discard any number of cards and draw that many cards. If it dies, deals X damage to each opponent and each planeswalker they control, where X is the number of land cards in your graveyard. That's fine. Chandra Flame Wave deals 2 damage to target player and each creature that player controls. Search your library and graveyard for Chandra Flame Fury, reveal upon your hand. Which is this one. Plus 1 deals 2 damage to any target, plus minus 2 deals 4 damage to any target, and 2 damage to the controller. 8 deals 10 damage to target player and each creature that player controls. Maw of Flames, when it Maw of Flame attacks, it deals 4 damage to any target and 3 damage to each of up to 2 other targets. Okay. Elvish Reclaimer. This is a good green card that I'll be running. It gets plus 2 if you have 3 or more land cards in the graveyard, but you pay 2, tap it to sacrifice a land, search your library for a land put into the battlefield tap. Not a basic land, any land. So a lot of green decks will be running this, I'm pretty sure, with the Lotus Field card. This land's not good. Whenever you tap a creature for mana, add another green. Land of War Elves are being cycled out of the set or the of standards, so you can't. We won't be able to play them soon. This is not that good because it's not that many wolves. Shifting Ceratops. This is the Teferi Killer. For 4, can't be counter, protection from blue, and then you can pay green to give it haste, trample, or reach. Basically, if you have 5 mana, you drop it, you hit Teferi right away. They can't block it. Unless they have creatures that aren't blue, but you know most Esper control decks don't have creatures. They can't counter it. They could technically mortify it, but that's unlikely. Vivian, Arcbow Ranger, +1. Distribute 2 +1/+1 counters among 2 target creatures. They gain champion until end of turn. Target creature you control deals damage to its power to target creature or planeswalker, so that just bites them. And choose a creature you own from outside the game and feel it and put in your hand. That could be good. I don't know what people will be doing using that for. Cavalier Thorns, enters the battlefield, reveal top 5 cards, put a land among them into the battlefield and the rest in your graveyard. When it dies, you may exile it. Put a target card from your graveyard on top of your library. Vivian's just gonna dick people. If your elk enters the battlefield, you may search your library for a graveyard named Vivian. Okay. Shared Summon. Search your library for 2 creature cards with different names revealed and put in your hand. That could be useful. Aggressive Mammoth is back. Vigilance. Hydra spells you cast cost 4 less to cast. Whenever a creature you control becomes a target of spell, this fights a creature you don't control. Hey, fuck you. It's that one Pokemon that burns their house down. Here's the other Vivian. Put 3 +1/+1 counters on target creature. Damn. Reveal cards of your library until you hit a creature card. Put it in your hand, the rest in the bottom. Or -6 target creature gets +10/+10 and trample until end of turn. Settle down. Pay 5. Untap target land. It becomes a 5/5 elemental with haste. Steal a land. Not until end of turn, so that could be good. Here's another Hydra. It enters the battlefield with X +1/+1 counters on it. When it enters the battlefield, double the number of counters on it or fight a creature I don't control. So this is good with this Hydra because even though this says this costs 4 less to cast, that 4 can actually go into X. So this, if you already have Gargos out, you can already dump 4X into this, which is pretty good. And then all the scry lands are out, which are pretty good. These are all the double lands for every color, except they let you scry, which is cool. Uh-oh. We good? I think we're good. I just saw a red box show up. Scrylands. Flying. Other multicolored creature spells you control get +1/+0. Whenever another multicolored creature you control dies, return it to its owner's hand at the beginning of the next end step. Fuck off. Flying Vigilance. Enters the battlefield, look at the top 6 cards, and we reveal an angel, demon, or dragon. Put in your hand. Omnath. When it enters the battlefield, it deals damage to any target equal to the number of elementals you control. when a land enters the battlefield under your control, put a +1/+1 counter on target elemental you control. If you control 8 or more lands, draw a card. Kethis. Legendary spells you control cast, one less to cast. Exile 2 legendaries from your graveyard. Each legendary in your graveyard gains. You may play this card from your graveyard. Pretty good if you're running a bunch of legendaries. Flying, whenever you cast a non-creature spell, create a 1/1 flying spirit. Sacrifice a spirit, add red. Death Touch Lifelink. If a permanent entering the battlefield causes ability or of a permanent you control to trigger that an additional time. Okay. When it enters the battlefield, search your library for a land card, put it onto the battlefield tapped, then shuffle your library. Exile the top 3 cards of your library. You may play them this turn without paying their mana costs. So for 7, you can start dropping shit. Just whipped a bitch? Hell yeah, Justin. Tell him. Field of the Dead enters the battlefield tapped. When Field of the Dead or another land enters the battlefield under your control, if you control 7 or more lands with different names, create a 2/2 black zombie creature. So here's the other stupid card. Lotus Field. Enters the battlefield tapped. Has hexproof, so it can't be targeted. When it enters the battlefield, sacrifice 2 lands, but it taps for 3 colors of any mana. You run that with fucking that white card. Brought back. Tap 2 lands for white. Play Lotus Field. Sacrifice 2 lands. Play Brought Back. Bring back the 2 lands that were sacrificed. Next turn you have 5 mana at least, unless you play another land. It's stupid. Bag of Holding, this goes really good with the dinosaur. Whenever you discard a card, exile it onto Bag of Holding, and then basically just sacrifice Bag of Holding, get all your cards back. So it's bad if they can blow it up, but I mean, if they blow it up, whatever. Grafdigger's Cage, this is great against players who want to go into their graveyards, which is not much in this set. Overseer sucks. As it enters the battlefield, choose a creature type. Creatures you control of the chosen type get +1/+1. Probably knights, elementals, dragons, and angels are going to be the more common picks. You may look at the top card of your library at any time. You may cast the top card of your library if it's an artifact or a colorless non-land card. Then they can pay to exile. So you can use this with that box to know what's on top of your deck. And then... Oh, was I already looking at Mythics too on accident? I was. Okay, well, whatever. Okay, let's open our packs and then let's see what the fuck we can make. I got Kethis. Not useful. Glinthorn. Unfortunately, nothing that I really wanted. Tail's End is fine. Nope, okay. Legion's End, don't care. Let's get 10 more packs. I should have, what, 9,000? Alright, show me something good. Fucking this ley line sucks. Reverberation. That's fine. We've got a scry land, drawn from dreams. God, looks like I'm gonna play blue, huh? I don't wanna play blue. Okay. Is there anything that we can make? Does it damage everyone? No, it only damages the creature that came into play. I kind of want to try to make that deck. How many wild cards do I have? I have 7. Alright, so I'm gonna... Here's what's gonna happen. I'm actually gonna modify my Gruul deck Oh, this is my mono green. I need to go on my gruel. So I'm gonna sub out the land or elves because those are gonna drop off. Girls chamber gardens will kill themselves. So with these. These will kill themselves. Okay, up a Galta. Up a Nissa. I want rares of Core 20. That I don't own as well. So I want three Marauding Raptors, I think. Do I want to go hard on the Marauding Raptors right now? I don't know. I think I only need to be able to draw one, so let's get only two. And then I need Elvish Reclaimers. I actually need a bunch of these. Three Elvish Reclaimers, and then I need Lotus Fields? How many is that? Well, that's seven wild cards. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, so I'm out of rares, but I have mythics. So, what kind of mythics can I pull out of here? What the hell? There we go. Chandra's Vivians. Not much for choices, huh? Okay, let's just do with what I own from anywhere. Null Height goes in, Biogenic goes in, and Godal Tyrannus? No, Carnage Tyrant. There we go. Okay, there's that. Let's fix the Krenko deck. So two Krenkos in. Please. Not collected. I want the red cards. A third Infuriate. We'll keep the Land of War Elves in because this is the jank deck and those are fine to be in here. Sure Strikes can stay in. I like the Thud and Act of Treason, but that's not the point of this deck, so I'll take those out. And I think I can drop a Collision Colossus. So, Craft All. Took one common. Okay, and now, let's make a jank deck that I can fight you guys with. I just don't know with what. Kethis. Enchantments, Leech, and Elvish Reclaimers, Rotting Raptors. I'm gonna need a lot more rare wild cards. Are you fighting someone with a 120 card deck? Are you serious? Who the fuck am I? What about Sephira? We're gonna put in one Sephira and see if we can make it work. Alright, we're gonna do blue-white flyers. That's what I've decided.
The last five games I played, they're all white weenies for some reason. They're not even running 2020 cards.
Yeah, because white weenies are so good. They're even better with 2020 now.
But none of them, they aren't playing any 2020 cards. So I wonder why it's making comeback.
I fight a lot of white weenies. They seem to get exactly lethal too, and it sucks ass. Ooh, let's get Shalai in here. Not two Shalai, just one Shalai. You can make over 160 card decks, Kyle. It's just not recommended. I don't know what the fuck I'm making here, but I'm making something. That seems good. Terramanders are not going to be that great. Farewell Winds will be fine. All the spirits don't care. Making mill you 160 times. Tempest Gen, I don't care about. Winged Words goes in. I guess Kefnet goes in. Dungeon Geist. I don't know what the fuck I'm making. Dovin. Actually, let's get rid of flying now. Let's see what kind of options we have. All the multicolor spells right now. Actually, where'd you go? I just saw you. Giddy can go in. I don't want that because it's too focused. I do want four, three of these. Unbreakable Formation's good. Conclave Tribunal. Stick two of those in there. Wander is cool. Oh, Knight the Beacon's expensive. Fuck out of here. I have an idea of what I want to make for a second deck already. Dovin's Veto, we need those, we need hand controls, we don't need acuities. I have too many cards. What's my, 16 creatures is not a lot. Guildgate, Glacial Fortress, Hollow Fountains, Meandering Rivers. That's fine. And shop two lands, and I think we're fine. Flying Jank. Alright, let's pick this other one. Hell yeah, dinosaurs. Here we go. Raptor hatchlings, they're gonna die. Needletooth. Basically, it's gonna kill itself, so I don't think I want that. Monstrosaurus and Tussidons. Burning Sun's Avatar is okay. Atali, I'll take. I don't like it that much, though. Fuck yeah, Brontodons. Added Stampede. Gigantosaurus doesn't cost any cheaper, so I don't want that. Tarnished Tyrant, Galtas. Hawley's Raptor. I actually can't play that. When this is dealt damage, each opponent sacrifices a permanent. Alright, it's fucking dumb. Okay, now let's get mana ramp. Lotus. What? Here we go. Two Lotus Fields. Gift of Paradises, Paradise Druids, and Incubation Druids? These are all going to die to Marauding Raptor, but I think the payoff will be fine. Okay, what else do I need? For red, green. Fuck, what's his name? Not Carnage Tyrant. Nullhide. Three. And then let's look at lands. Oop, not that one. Oop on, Stomp the Ground, Timberland Gorges. Okay. Dino. Dino, fine. Doni. Soar. Okay. Do I have a Goreclaw in there? I do not. I should put a Goreclaw in there. Actually, while I'm at it, I'll put the other good green cards in here. Tender Shoot. Biogenic Ooze. What can I drop? Probably the Sword Toots. Probably don't need the Raptor Hatchings either. Drop the Knights? This deck is jank enough. I don't know if you realize this, but I have no instants or sorceries. It's literally just creatures, so I think it's jank enough. So whatever I get, it's literally what you see. Well, we'll try it. If it's not jank enough, I'll put something else in. Kyle, I guess I'll play you first with my Flying Jank. Because my Flying Jank sucks. That is for sure jank. Where did Justin go? Is Justin still here? Oh, Justin's here. Kyle, where you at? Oh, there he is. Bitch, I don't need your code. We'll see how this goes. Alright, Kyle, I'll play you with my two decks, and then Justin, I'll play with my two decks, and then we'll see how we feel. Let's not talk about this curve. He's a furry? Kyle, why are you a furry? You going somewhere?
No.
What are you doing? Alright, whatever. Uh-oh, where did Kyle go? What am I doing? There we go. Let me drop the healer talk without any mana. Alright, step one done. Get in there, cock. Chart that course. This is actually not a bad rollout now. Wow, the music got really epic for no fucking reason. What's happening? Does he have a counter spell? Does not.
I am here to aid in the assault.
Get.
Prepare for battle.
Vigilance. Hit him. I wish I can give a double lifelink. Alright, Kyle, what are you doing over there? This is actually an extremely lucky hand. It started out bad, but it curved out quite nicely because of Charter Course. Alright, what do we got? It flies. You're casting instant sorcery spell, Wizard's Control, okay. Yeah, you can hit him. Not right. Sure.
Share in my light.
I can tell that Kyle's getting mana screwed because I'm at 5 lands and he has 3. Why would I want to... Why is it asking me to reveal this? Oh, Kefnet. You may reveal the first card you draw each turn. The copy costs 2 less to cast. Sure, reveal. Fucking do it again. I don't have a blue. I made a mistake. That's fine. Here we go. You are indestructible.
I believe in you.
Kyle, where's your land? Did you get a land? Oh, we got a. Oh, what the fuck is fucking 5 colors? Oh, that gives me an idea. Okay, like you just gave me another idea for a super jank deck. Is this 5 color high alert? Yeah, you got it. Interesting. That played way better than it should have. Hold on. I gotta do this now. Mythics. Kefnet. Spawn of Mayhem. Gideon. Hissipanalia. 2 Lilianas. Not Null High Ferrix. Get out of here. God damn it. And the rarest too. Oh, yeah, Kyle, I noticed a lot of your lands are dual color, but I'm gonna try something. Mini Teferis. Vraska's good. Two of these Karns, three Mobilized Districts. And then two Ugins. And then let's get Gift of Paradises. Lotus Fields. Land of War Elves. What else has mana ramp? I guess I can do Paradise Stewards. And then, let's go to lands. Okay, here we go. I have how many lands to play with? 1, 2. I'm hoping I don't put too many lands in. Okay, do I have any basic lands? I still have 3/4, so... Okay, solid. No basic lands. Five color mid-range. Oh, I have to have a sideboard. You're gonna fight this deck? Hell yeah. Alright, hold on. We gotta make a sideboard real quick. So I need artifacts. I need specifically... Don't need that. That should be fine. Crucible World is good. Two Sorcerer's Spyglass. Sure, Mana Geode, I don't care. Dragon Horde. Firemind's Vessel. God Pharaoh Statues. Medium Golems, and... What else should I put in there? Put a wall in, why not? Hell yeah, super jank. Okay, Cal. Cal, I'll give you... Actually, no, let's switch out to Justin. Justin, what do you want to fight? And then I'll go back to Kyle, and you guys can choose which deck to fight. Out of any of these, pretty much. But, I mean, here are my jank decks. And my and my Krenko. Alright, I'm going to fight Justin with this. And then I'll fight Kyle again with whatever. And then eventually I'll play some regular Magic. Ew! Why are you an old lady? Get out of here! What happened? No, baby! Dude, you're fucking... You're Jaya right now. Look how old you are. Hell yeah. Oh, nice sleeves, dude. Oh, you know what? Justin, your thing is might be set to, random. Oh, mine might be set to random, too. I have to check that. What the fuck are you doing? I'm not blocking that shit. Get out of here. You think I am? Damn, I forgot that was gonna come with the play tapped. Alright, what are you dropping? What is this mana deck? Alright, blue. Megathopter.
I can benefit from another's success.
No tax. Until end of turn, whenever a creature I control deals combat damage to a player, put a loyalty counter on Dovin. I can create a Thopter, gain one life with 7, look at the top 7 cards of my library, put 3 in my hand, the rest at the bottom. It's okay, he's dead.
This is a rare occasion.
What the fuck? Where's the red? Oh, hell yeah. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Con doctor. Let's just get in there, huh? He casted it using this. You can add 1 color of any mana. That's why I was like, what the fuck just happened? It's only this specific elf. This one says add green. But this one says any color. Okay. Can you kill it again? Oh, fucking, are you serious? You can kill it again? What just happened? What just happened? Alright, real talk. Like that? This one. Justin, what is this fucking situation going on?
My purpose is greater than myself.
Did you get a creature? Oh, we got a firebrand, it's gonna explore. Shoot, Karn, I dare you. Yeah, you got it.
Not every fight can end in victory.
Come on, game. You can do it. Teferi, Hero Dominaria. Alright, well, that's dumb. Dude, yeah, you got no fucking creatures. What's going on? I'm waiting for the creature. Anything? Hell yeah, Paradise Druid. Fucking mana ramp. We got a Vivian. Damage Banefire. Oh baby, he's gonna kill my mobilize district. You know, I was kind of expecting him to just throw everyone at the Llanowar Elf. My bubble sister came back. That's fucking stupid. Alright, Justin, that sucked. Kyle. What do you want? You got booted? Are you serious? Which jank deck do you want? If you don't choose one, Justin, I'll have you choose one for Kyle. Singleton? Fuck yeah, let's do Singleton. Not great. Better. You're gonna have to go away for now. God damn it. Hit me. Hell yeah. Get out there. Get out there. Alright, green black so far. Doesn't seem like you can cast anything for four, which is kind of concerning. Can you cast something for five? No! Kyle, what are you doing? I'm just gonna do this just to be safe. Mud elf. You know, I thought the elf may have been a better idea. Kyle, what the fuck is your hand? What are you doing over there? Black? Did you draw black? Do a green. Great. Kyle, what did you have? Did you not get another black source? All right, Justin, what do you want? Five colors? Minimum cost six? What the fuck? That's some jank ass shit. Okay, and you want? You guys come up with some condition for me to play to make jank, and I'll make a jank deck off of it. That needs to settle down. Well, apparently you're Vivian now, too. How do you like my tap lands? Oh god, this is the shit again. Hit me for zero. Oh, the good side is, the good thing about this is I have all white. Who's a hot brunette? What do you mean? What are you talking about? Does he mean Nissa? Hello, I am Karn.
I advise that you yield. I'll make you.
Oh, this is Nissa, if that's what you're talking about. Or do you mean Chandra? Oh yeah, that's Chandra. Listen, we might have a problem. What am I supposed to do here? I think we might be fine. Made a mistake. We're fine. That one and that one.
Good choice.
Of course he would give me Karn. Why would he not? Alright, he's got a lot of fat bottom bitches over there, I don't like it. I mean, if you're offering to throw your tender shoot at me, sure. I swear to god, that was another 10 to shoot, I was gonna be mad. kill the fuck out of that. And that. Alright. He needs to settle the fuck down a little bit. Can I do anything to gain life? One, two, three, four. Oh man, I wish I had a Palaka worm. My hand's expensive. I don't think I have enough lockers. Oh, what a dick! Are you fucking serious? Fucking no blocks. What a dick. You can't block me. Alright, let me see what this shit's about. I haven't set the Nissa.
We will not fail. I'm the best fire starter there is. Witness the ties that bind us all.
Hell yeah. Congrats, Justin. I was like, why did you send your tender shoot at me? But I guess it didn't matter. Okay. I'll be you again. Don't choose war on my ass. Oh, you definitely don't want new deck too. That's actually a decent deck. What happened? Where'd it go? Oh, I guess I chose a deck. I want to try out this dinosaur deck eventually. Oh, this pro-life deck actually won't even run because that's for the event. But I mean, I can try it. Where the fuck did Kyle go? Is he here? Alright, I'm gonna give Kyle like 20 seconds to choose a deck, otherwise I'll fight you, Justin. God, I really like this Krenko deck. What do you want me to play, Kyle? That's what I'm asking you. Bot match. Alright, fuck it, Kyle. I'm playing dinosaurs. I don't expect the dinosaurs to work, but I'm gonna try it. Literally creatures, no combat tricks. This hand sucks. This hand's better. I've seen this before. Last game? It's not the last game, it's only 9. Keep fucking playing. You got me. Oh, yeah. I did see that strat last game. Okay, settle the fuck down. Clear that board. Hell yeah. No attacks. We're just hanging out here. Alright, well, now you're causing a problem. Nine. Oh, that's fucking dumb. I can only block it one. Oh, damn it. I should have played Galta. Oh, I got cheeky. Ooh, that was close. I forgot I can only block it with one creature. God damn it. Oh, that was... But that deck did stupid things, so... That's great. I did not fucking... Prestigious Growth. That was good. That was very good. Justin, what do you want? Cranko. Okay. Too bad Zach works until 9:30. I wanted to play some rounds with him. Oh, dude, look at that sick background. It's a Lotus Field. I'm not Gideon. You, get out of here. I mean, you're showing as Vivian Reed for me, and I'm showing as Nissa, and you've been Vivian. No, yours has been random. The new Mulligan is actually really good. I think it's just fucking around. Did you make a deck just for my Cranko? I swear to... Did you actually try to make a deck for my Cranko? Alright, you know what? Since we're fucking around, I'll give you one more. Let's play another one. And then we'll go back to Kyle. And you also got Super Land screwed, which is dumb. Go, oh god, get out of here, Teferi! Fuck off! I'm leaving this game. I'm not Teferi, you're Teferi. Get the fuck out of here. This new Mulligan rule is amazing. I forgot what I was playing, but I kept referring to that meme. Oh, I was playing Final Fantasy X-2, and you can capture monsters. And, I was using the monsters against same monsters, so they were basically the same thing fighting each other, and I was like, Spider-Man meme. People, it's a good game at the same time. Oh, does he have a... Oh, maybe. He might. Oh, he doesn't.
It's a beautiful day for me. Oh, I wish you could see your face while I'm beating you.
Guys, this deck is so fucking dumb. Get out of here, Teferi! Yeah, I'll send you the deck list. Did I fuck up your Land of War Elf plan? where's my Facebook? Alright, Kyle. What do you want to play? Oh, I knew I had to kill your elf, Justin. I just had a feeling. Alright, I sent you the deck list. Obviously, the deck's not great, but it's fucking funny. Yeah, but I also mulled because I didn't have a Krenko. The options lower down are better. Well, this deck doesn't work because this works on... I can't play this because this is specifically for an event. Cascade is also for an event. Cats is okay. Poop on them is my red... My first version of my green deck. Green Chon is my highest tier deck. This is my burn deck. This is my discard deck. This is commons only. I don't know what the fuck this is about. What's this deck? Oh, this is also commons only, but for green. Big Bottom Bitches deck, you know that. Singleton, it's Gruul, but only one of. Proliferate, this deck is based off of counters. This is an actual deck, but only the previous three sets. This is my version 2 of my green Stompy. This is my actual Gruul deck. Krenko. The Flying Jank, Dinosaur, and 5-color midrange, so... Cats can be aggressive, discard is annoying to deal with, poor, and poor 2, I guess. Oh, I can't rename it. Impressive Team Edward, hell yeah, vampires, let's go. I like how I said you're Teferi, and you're like, you're Teferi! Justin, if it's nice out, do you want to go disc golfing on Thursday? Or Friday? No! Kyle, why the fuck are you Teferi? That's not okay. This hand sucks, but I'll play it. Tentacle Gargoyle. So with the new London Mulligan rule, you're pretty much... If you mull, you're basically fine. So it's pretty good to just straight up mull. God, two of these lands suck. Look, I'll play something eventually. Just don't worry about it. Well, this isn't gonna go well. I'm waiting. Hey, I might be able to do something. That one. Hell yeah, we got some life. We're not dead yet. Mm-hmm. I literally did nothing but play lands. Oh, this deck sucks. You want to try that again? At least it's jank. That's what matters. Okay, something else. I want to get that dinosaur deck to work. This is actually going to be a basis of a deck that I'm going to make. This is going to be the foundation of my new Gruul deck, I think. Tezzeret. At least you're not Teferi. I guess. I mean, I can only draw creatures or lands, so... Cat? Cat. Let's give me a 3. I'll have 4 next turn. But I'll need 5, so let's just do this. Oh. The people who pick Jace avatars? The people who actually have like the paid for avatars are also not that great. Okay, I need to fucking chill out. That's unfortunate. Let's just chill out, huh? Do I care? No. No, don't do that. Jesus Christ. Listen, I think we're fine still. We might have an issue now. Thing is, if I attack with the Tali, I won't get anything good from Kyle's deck. But I'm on a clock if I don't do anything. Yellow. Oh, fucking great! God damn it. Play them, they're free. God, I didn't realize this Gideon's Company card was so fucking good. Oh, frames. What is happening? Is it Twitch? What's happening? I guess we'll just finish the fight. I mean, I'm basically dead anyway, so. Clearly my internet works, so something's going on. What the fuck? OBS says it's reconnected, but I got nothing. Alright, well, that's the end of the recording. See ya.